Hi guys, it's Marty here from letsbuildwp.com, and in this video we're going to be covering how to install WordPress on Bluehost web hosting. And for anyone who doesn't know already, Bluehost are one of the most popular hosting companies for WordPress. They include a free domain name with all of their hosting packages, and they're even recommended by WordPress.org themselves as their top choice for hosting. If you already have a Bluehost account and just want to know how to install WordPress, you can skip ahead to the time on screen now. Then for everyone else, we're going to open up our internet browser and go to bluehost.com. Or if you want to support this channel and get a discount on your order at the same time, you can use my affiliate link in the video description. I'll earn a small commission if you do this, and you'll also get a great discount. Then once we get here, we're going to hover over Hosting and Websites at the top and click Shared Hosting. Then if we scroll down, we'll see the different hosting plans that Bluehost offer. If you're just getting started with WordPress, I'd recommend going for the basic plan. This allows us to create one single website, and it comes with a free domain name for a year. Or if you're wanting to build more than one website, you could go for the Choice Plus plan. But this is really up to you. Then once we've decided on our plan, we just need to click Select. That's going to bring us to this page, and this is where we're going to register the domain name for our new WordPress website. So we just need to type whatever we're wanting to register as our domain name into this box on the left, and for my example, I'm going to type Marty's website. Then on the right we can choose our domain extension, and I'm going to choose .com. So the domain name I'm registering here is martyswebsite.com. Then we're going to click Next. And when we do, we'll hopefully get a message at the top of the screen telling us the domain is available. But if it comes up and says the domain is not available, we will need to choose something else. Then, as long as it's available, underneath we can enter our account information, so things like our name and address. Then, under this it says Package Information, and here we'll see that it's only going to cost me $35.40 for 12 months of hosting, which works out at around $2.95 per month. And we also get our domain for free. Then below this it says Package Extras, and these are just some added extras that Bluehost offer. Personally, I don't want any of these, so I'm just going to uncheck the boxes. But you can have a read through them yourself and check the box beside any you want. Then under this we can enter our payment details, or we can choose PayPal. Then finally, down at the bottom, we just need to click Submit. At this point we'll either see a payment processing screen, or we'll be redirected to PayPal to log in and pay for our order. Then after paying for our order, we're going to get a message saying congratulations, you successfully created your account. Now we're going to click Create Password. Enter the password we want to use for logging into our Bluehost account, and click Create Password. Then we need to type in the new password, and then click Next to log in. When we first create our Bluehost account, it'll automatically bring us through the WordPress installation process. But if we've already done this before, we just need to click into WordPress Hosting on the left, then click Add Site over to the right. Make sure Install WordPress is selected on this screen, and then click Continue on the right. And this will bring us back to the screen we started on. Now we can enter our site title, and don't worry too much about this for now, as we can always change it again later. Then click Continue on the right. Now we need to enter the domain name we're wanting to use for our WordPress site, so for me, this is going to be martyswebsite.com. Then if we click Continue, Bluehost is going to start installing WordPress right away. This will usually only take about 30 seconds or so to complete, but sometimes it can take a little longer. Then once WordPress has been installed, we just need to click these three dots to the right, and click Login. At this point, we might get a message saying, this site is using a temporary URL until your domain is pointed at Bluehost. If this is a new domain name, it might take a few hours to finish setting up. But once our new domain name is ready, it'll replace the temporary one right away without us needing to do anything. Now we just need to click Login to WordPress on the right. And this will open up our WordPress website in a new tab. When we first install WordPress on Bluehost, we'll be prompted to use their WordPress onboarding process. If we want to use this, we just need to click Start Setup, and Bluehost will guide us through a few different customization options for our new website. But personally, I feel like it's better to start with a fresh WordPress installation and then making any changes ourselves. So if we want to skip the onboarding process and head straight to our site, we just need to click Exit to WordPress in the top left, then click Exit in the middle, and this will bring us straight into the WordPress dashboard, which is where we can start adding content and customizing our WordPress website. Then, to visit our site, we need to click our site title in the top left, and this will show us what WordPress looks like when we first install it. And don't worry if yours looks a little different than mine, as sometimes they change up the default theme. Either way, it's just going to have some demo content on it for now, but it's ready for us to start customizing and adding content to. Then, to get back to the dashboard, we just need to click our site title again in the top left. Then, finally, if you registered your domain name from somewhere else or using a different Bluehost account, you will need to point the domain name to your new website before it will update. I'll link to a tutorial in the description that'll show you how this is done. But for everyone else, our domain name will automatically change to the one we just registered as soon as Bluehost have finished setting it up. So that's us now at the end, and that was how to install WordPress on Bluehost. I really hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, please give it a like here on YouTube to show your support, and consider subscribing to the channel for more WordPress tutorials in future. Then, if you have any questions about installing WordPress, feel free to ask them in the comments, and I'll try my best to help out when I can. Once again, my name's Marty from letsbuildwp.com, and thank you very much for watching.